I thought I'd share an idea for students that are wanting to better improve their knowledge and want to be able to make more out of an educational institution than what they are at the moment. Have you ever thought that when you go to an academic institution, that it's really you, the one that's paying money, and for that quality of money, you should be wanting to get good service in return to ensure that everything is working properly and you have access to learning resources and so forth? I just have an idea that would, it's up to you whether you want to adopt it, of course, but to be able to make the educational learning a lot more interesting and a lot more challenging. What I would encourage is for students that are in, say, university, that are doing courses or whatever, to get to know other students in your class and to find out what strengths and weaknesses you and your fellow colleagues have within an academic environment. For example, you may know someone that is in the in your class that's a geek, or someone that is very knowledgeable with their subject and may be very good with reading and being able to interpret data or whatever. Now, it might be for you that a weakness might be that you might have some issues with procrastination and may find it hard to be able to retain information. But why not have some sort of a bartering system where, for example, you might have a friend that's in university and you might be studying, say, science, for example, and the friend might be very good having a knowledge of facts and figures, but you might also have a very good knowledge or you might have some attributes in being good at, say, sport, like rugby league's very popular in Australia or something like that. Maybe you could exchange some of your knowledge. I don't quite know how I'm going to go with this, but I'm trying to get people thinking in this atmosphere. You could be able to exchange some of your interests with that of a fellow, with your fellow students. Be able to have someone that is knowledgeable in your area. And being able to not just rely on them, but to be able to see them as someone that you can share information from. Also to reward yourself and others. So, for example, in an academic environment, you might be finding that your course syllabus is dry, or you might be finding your neat reading list is very narrow. Why not be able to go beyond that and find a way to expand that reading list so that you can obtain more information? For example, working in the library sector or in other areas, there might be people that, when they're exposed to learning resources, may have a great deal of knowledge and wisdom to share. And that way, they're learning as much as you are from that knowledge. So, for example, there might be two or three books and they may not be available in the resource centre, in the library, or whatever. Rather than just say yay, nay and get frustrated, why not search around to find where that knowledge can be ascertained, where you can acquire it? Find other people around you, or perhaps go to areas of where this interest may be. For example, if you're doing, say, history, why not go and visit a historical society? Or why not contact a historical society, say, for example, if you're studying American history and you're looking at the Revolutionary War, why not contact, say, the Trenton Museum in the United States, or not the museum, but the historical society or something? I mean, this might be all common knowledge and it might be tested before, but an academic environment should be a learning environment, and you should be. It's always a good idea to be able to extract as much information and knowledge out of that environment as possible. So, why not simply ask and seek to discover and just look around in your fellow, with your fellow students or accessing your library or whatever, and asking staff members or asking other students what they know, what they would like to see, or what they find difficult or challenging in the subject, and then take that to the academic or the professor and start saying, well, I have my own point of view, what do you think? Or start asking more questions and looking for answers. I think too much these days, it's the syllabuses are often just pushed out and regurgitated, and there's no real input of new information and knowledge. And I think that to make an environment more exciting and energetic, I think sometimes one does have to push the envelope and ask questions to seek answers. So when you look at your class, for example, and you're paying your fees to attend university, why don't you look around at the fellow students and whether there might be some students that you might think are nerdish or geekish? Maybe you could be contacting them and making contact with them and finding out what they know and what you can exchange with them. That they may welcome you being a friend to them, for example. They might want to hang out with you somewhere as much as you might want to share knowledge from them. So there's always a way to make for a more interesting and educational setting. And for any ideas, comments or suggestions, please feel free to contact me on this video channel. Thanks very much for watching.